What's up, you guys? I hope you guys are doing amazing and everything is safe and sound in your hometowns. Today, I'm here to talk about one of the most important things which I request you guys to follow from now onwards. I very well remember the journey that we have had from the past 3 months while I started talking about university and preparations to actually helping you guys get through your university and then definitely talking in detail about college and how you guys should survive college. I still remember while I was helping you guys prepare for CUET exams, there was this one section which actually troubled a lot of you people, which was current affairs. I don't blame you guys, while even I was giving my CUET exams, this section was one of the pains for me too. Just because we all coming from class 12 exams and giving our boards to actually giving the college entrance exams, there's a lot of difference. And specifically, just because we are too busy in studying our core subjects that we actually leave behind current affairs. For that time, we actually just manage by buying books, going through online material, reading newspapers, and just somehow surviving and clearing the current affairs section of the exam and getting admission to our respective colleges. But I just want to tell you guys that the battle is not over. And that current affairs is going to be one thing which is going to be there with you forever. And if you don't catch it and get a hold of it now, it is surely going to bother you and trouble you throughout. Current affairs as a genre is super important for you throughout life. No matter wherever you go, no matter which company you work in, no matter what you start, where you end up with, it is really going to play a big role and a major role in how you upbring yourself. Even more specifically, in college, it is going to be super important because current affairs will actually help you through your course materials for any of the courses that you are joining, be it law, be it journalism, be it management, any of the courses. These are the topics that you will be discussing about in your classes, with your friends, wherever you go, meet entrepreneurs, meet business managers, anybody and everybody that you go and have a conversation with. There's definitely going to be some or the other talk relating to current affairs. I mean, I can go on talking about how important current affairs is going to be. I still remember just when I had so much of struggling time while I was giving my CUET exam specifically for current affairs, I made this promise to myself then that even after my CUET exams are done and then I get admission to the college I really want to, I won't leave current affairs from then on. And thankfully, by God's grace, I kept maintaining it, and throughout college till date today, I make sure that I regularly keep in touch with current affairs. There are n number of advantages, but yes, I hope you guys get the point that you all need to up your game and be regularly in touch with current affairs. Now, the question comes of how you guys should be in touch with current affairs. Frankly, you guys know the app that I majorly use for my current affairs, which is InShorts. So if you haven't downloaded it till now, make sure that you download it. I'll drop a link in the description below of InShorts. They aren't paying me, but yes, since it has helped me a lot, I would recommend it wholeheartedly to each one of you. Reading newspaper is very important. Either you can do it online or even offline, whichever you're comfortable with is surely great. Still, the quality of content of The Hindu and The Economics Times is great. So even if you have to subscribe to that, make sure that you do it. So now that you guys know how important current affairs is, I'm going to share a little anecdote with you guys that has helped me throughout. While I was moving to Bangalore for the very first time, I was intrigued by the startup culture there. And that's when I really started reading a lot about the startup culture. Now, the biggest companies in the country were actually just starting then in 2014, 2015. And how they have grown throughout has been a great learning experience for me. And yes, I won't lie to you guys, but I definitely read about each of those companies from the day zero, from the time I actually decided that I need to keep in touch. Current affairs and general knowledge is huge. And definitely there are going to be some topics which are going to be of your liking and you will surely be reading a lot about them. And then there are going to be some topics which you are not really familiar with or you do not want to go in depth about it, but you still should know of whatever is happening around, at least from the top of it. India as a country is growing at a great pace, and the major sectors which are booming are like the startup sector. where all the young entrepreneurs are forming great companies which are actually changing the way people are living and solving great problems. Now, what does this have for people like you and me? Frankly, as far as I see it, it is a lot of learning for me. While I read about all these companies and whatever they're doing currently, I just get to know of how they're tackling their problems, how are they moving ahead of challenges, and how is the company X, Y, or Z growing. I don't want to bug you guys with a lot of detail, but yes, surely I will just be leaving you guys with a few names and a few startup battles that you must follow from now on. And definitely this is going to be a lot of learning for each one of you. The startups that you need to follow are like Uber versus Ola, which is like the aggregator cabs. And trust me, the battle that they are having in between them is amazing. And how they tackle their driver problems, how they're having new customers, how are they providing discounts and solutions, everything is amazing. And trust me, they keep it head to head with each other. Whatever Uber is doing, Ola gets into it. Whatever Ola is doing, Uber tries to get into it. And then a lot of funding, a lot of innovation. So there's a lot of learning. Second thing that you need to follow is relating to foods and beverages and the delivery system, which is Zomato and Swiggy. So yes, when it comes to innovation and creativity, these two are head to head yet again. I don't need to talk much about it. I'm pretty sure you are already ordering from Zomato and from Swiggy. The third startup battle which you all need to follow, and I'm pretty sure indirectly you guys are already following it, is like Prime versus Netflix versus Hotstar versus Z5 and all the OTT platforms. We all already know how they're trying to battle with each other in terms of any genre, be it stand-up comedy, be it documentaries, be it movies, be it originals. Like, you actually need to follow and read up a lot about OTT, as that is like the future of content and how content is going to be consumed in the future. The fourth that you need to follow is like the Paytm Mall versus Amazon versus Flipkart versus Snapdeal, which is like the e-commerce sector. Like, the e-commerce sector has changed the way people shop. Everybody today is sitting in their home, scrolling through the phone, are ordering whatever they want to. E-commerce is growing, and we all need to learn whatever we can of how these people are battling it out. The fifth and the last startup battle that you need to follow, and I'm pretty sure again, you already will be following it indirectly, which is like the hotel sector, the hospitality sector, which is Oyo versus Tribo versus Fab Hotels, and then X number of other similar startups. So as you would know, hospitality has changed ever since Oyo entered the market. They've decreased the rates of hospitality sector. They've made hospitality standardized. And just after Oyo, there were a lot of other startups which have entered the sector, and they have a cut-to-cut competition when it comes to pricing, when it comes to gaining properties, when it comes to having customer acquisition. These are like the five startup battles that you need to follow. I know that there are a lot more of the startups that you can follow, but it is just like a little value bomb that I wanted to drop in this video of how you guys can go about reading a lot about like the current affairs and the startup culture. I hope if you guys consider me your mentor and your elder brother, from today onwards itself, you will start reading about current affairs. Trust me, this has zero money involved. Everything is free. All it needs is you and your important time. That you need to sit in front of your laptops, you need to pick up books, you need to read up newspapers. And it's just about developing a habit. The day you start doing it, maybe first day, second day, third day is like a big pressure that you are actually forcing yourself to actually sit down and read. But once you really start, it's just going to come as a natural habit. And then you will get so eager about reading. Like, just in case if one day is the day that you skip, you will be just so eager to read about whatever is happening. And if you start entering into these startup battles like I did when I joined college, I couldn't stay a day without reading about these startup battles. I was so engrossed in knowing what Uber is doing, what Ola is doing, how is Netflix trying to beat Amazon Prime, Hotstar. So I hope this video has been useful for you all. Thank you so much for watching this video till the very end. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. Comment below if you have any doubts, questions or queries. I will surely try replying to all of them. And lastly, do not forget to subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you receive regular notifications about any video that I upload. So take care, bye-bye.